video, we'll provide an overview of Testim, the first automation platform to use AI to improve the authoring and stability of both UI and end-to-end tests. We're also the most flexible low-code tool, enabling you to use JavaScript to modify any test. So here's a brief agenda of what we're going to cover. We'll talk about how quickly and how dramatically you can increase your authoring time of tests. We'll talk about different ways to configure tests. We'll touch on test stability and how we dramatically reduce the time it takes to maintain tests. Different ways to execute tests and how all this ties into test ops. Things like tagging failures, looking at results, filtering, etc. Let's get started. So what we're seeing here is Testim's visual editor, which you would use for the editing, debugging, or creation of tests. Tests in Testim are both made up of both manually recorded and or custom actions. And you can see here that each test step is represented as a tile in the test canvas. Now each test step in Testim, you can set different properties. For example, I can change the URL of the application under test. I can put in a name, I can put in a description. I could do some more advanced configurations if I wanted to. I could also pass in test data, which can be used for more data-driven testing. Let's go ahead and click on record. And as you can see, as we start interacting with the page, anything we do shows up as a tile in the test canvas. More importantly, in this particular thumbnail, we can see the object that we're actually interacting with on the page, which makes understanding and interpreting what the test is doing much easier. Let's go ahead and continue. You noticed here it said, do you want to auto record your steps? We're going to select no. We're going to touch on reusable components a little bit later here in the demo. And let's go click login and we'll go ahead and stop the recording. So we can see here, we've recorded a basic login flow. You can drag and drop steps. You can move steps around if you wanted. We can delete steps if we wanted to do that. Completely flexible in how you do that. If we go here and click on Testim predefined steps and expand validations, we provide a number of other things you could do within the context of Testim. We could validate the downloading of a PDF or a text file. We can generate dynamic email addresses, which could be used in end-to-end tests. But in this login example, we want to validate that we're logged in with the appropriate user. So we're going to click validate login text, which is contextual. And let's say I wanted to continue recording and click log out. I can do that as well. So we can see here that we've recorded a nice login flow here. We'll go ahead and play this back. If we're using a conventional tool like Selenium, creating a test like this might take an hour or two. As you can see here, we've reduced that to about a minute. And as you can see here, the test completed. So at the beginning of the demo, you noticed there was that pop-up that said, do we want to reuse these reusable components? We said no. Let's say we actually wanted to do that. So let's say everything up to the login, we wanted to create and put into a specific shared group. If I click shared group, this would be available for any test, okay, that this group is shared with. I'm not going to select that. I'm going to click confirm. And you can see all these steps have been put into this group. So you might ask, why would I create a group? Common flows like log in, log out, put something in the shopping cart, search for a product. Flows are use cases that are going to be leveraged across hundreds or thousands of tests. It's always good to create a reusable set of steps. In Testim, we refer to those as groups. And as you can see here, it does a couple of things. Not only does it make it easier to maintain, because if I want to make a change, all I need to do is make it to this shared step or this shared group. The other thing about it, it dramatically reduces the complexity of the test and it makes the test much easier to interpret and read. So we're going to go ahead and set a breakpoint here. One of the other big challenges that comes up when working with automation is the concept of constantly having to maintain tests that are broken. Tests break for a variety of reasons. Developers make changes, objects change on the page, things change, and as an automation team or as a development team, you need to go back and constantly fix things that break. So as you can see here, what we're doing with this particular application here is we're actually going and simulating what it would be like if something was to change on the page, which is a very common problem in automation and working with different automated tools like Selenium. So as you can see here, we're gonna go ahead and move the button. Okay. So as you can see here, we made a couple of changes. So we changed the color of the button, we changed the text, and we changed the class name. If we're using a conventional tool, something like Selenium, typically we're using one locator strategy. So if that one locator was to fail, the entire test is going to break and fail. So now what we're going to do is we're going to click play. It's going to pick up right where that step left off. And as you can see, even after changing the color of the button, the text, and the class name, we were still actually able to find that object. How is that possible? What is really going on here? So with Testim, we use our artificial intelligence algorithm, and we capture all of this information about this particular login button. Unlike a conventional tool like Selenium that uses one locator strategy, we use dynamic locators. So you can see all of these different things are used to determine what this login button is. We also create a score for each one of these particular locators, which generates a probability of how likely we are to find this particular object, which in this case was the login button. And even after we made three or four changes, we were still able to actually find that object. The other great thing about Testim is that all of this can be customized. So for example, let's say I wanted to edit text. Maybe instead of equals, I wanted to change this to contains. I could do that. I could actually uncheck text so it would not actually be part of the algorithm in determining what this login button was. Finally, I could come in here and I could change the threshold of how likely we are to find that object. It's set to low, but I could make this strict or very high if I wanted to make any sort of customization or changes there. As you can see here, the test passed. We ran this test locally, but again, with Testim, and we'll be showing you this a little bit later in the demo, we also can determine where we want to run this. If we want to run on the Testim grid, we can do that. We also can run on any other Selenium compatible grid. So as we can see here, if we click here, each test step in Testim, we record a screenshot for each test execution. The first time it runs, we're going to create a baseline. Here we can see a side-by-side comparison and a result of the object we're looking at. This really helps with things like root cause analysis and diagnosing deeper problems if a test was to break. Also, we provide you access to the console log. We provide you access to the network log if you wanted to have access to that. Maybe the application threw an exception, you need to see what's happening. We also support full branching and merging for the source control or test case management as well, test cases. If we come here to the test library, we can see now that we've showed you how to create a test quickly, how we dramatically reduce test maintenance. Now it's really moving into the concept of test ops. How do we manage these tests going forward? We provide a number of mechanisms to do that. We can create folders, organize tests that way. We can create labels and apply labels to tests if we wanted to do that. Another thing that we offer here, obviously we know what pass or fail is, but within Testim, you actually can create a test status. So tests that are in draft or evaluating, if you add those to your CI pipeline, if those tests were to fail, they're actually not going to fail the build, which allows you to add tests that are sort of in an experimental stage. Once tests are in a solid state where they're passing consistently, you can move them to active, okay? Briefly wanted to touch on test plans. Test suites are pretty self-explanatory. A test plan is more of an advanced test suite. I could pass in tests that have a certain label associated with them. I could pass in a test suite, and here I can actually create different configurations. We support all of these different operating systems. We also support the ability to run on both emulator and simulator. And we support all the major browsers, Chrome, Firefox, Edge, Safari, Internet Explorer as well. So for this particular test plan, we're going to run across any test that has this particular label across all of these browser OS combinations in parallel. Okay. If we come over here and want to give you some insights into the test case management, obviously at a very high level, we've been in the testing business a long time. We've really helped companies achieve a high level of success, and we really help teams scale and grow and be much more efficient. So at a very high level, beyond just showing you tests and being able to show you how we reduce test maintenance or increase authoring time, we also help teams be more efficient. And one way we do that is with our test ops dashboard. And as you can see here, as a practitioner, when I show up for the first day of work, I really need to understand, what do I need to focus on? What needs my immediate attention? So I can click here and I can look at tests that are assigned to me. I can get some insight into the last remote executions, how long those took to run. If we scroll down here, we provide a nice high level overview of what the test cases and the test case state. And we can see we have 19 in draft. So let's say we're doing an agile sprint. I created some stubs for tests. I need to go in and quickly automate these tests so they can be part of the sprint. We can also look at quarantine. So quarantine is a case where tests maybe were failing. We wanted to mark them as quarantine, which reminds me that I need to go back and figure out what happened with these test cases and quickly fix them as quickly as possible. Duplication level. We have an algorithm called alter grouping. It runs periodically through the week. It scans hundreds or thousands of different tests. It looks for duplicate steps, and from a behavior standpoint, is trying to drive the user to create reusable groups, which we touched on some of the benefits of those earlier. I'm not going to go ahead and do this, but if I clicked on create shared group, not only would it create a shared group, it would apply that to each one of these tests and refactor any of the tests that were associated in this list here. We come down here a little bit further, we can see recent activity. If I wanted to look at a recent test that I had modified, I can easily do that here. We also support the concept of pull requests. If I wanted to quickly look at tests that were going to be merged back into the master, I could see that and either approve or deny that particular request. Briefly touching on test executions and test runs, we can come in here and we can look at a longer period of time, and we can look at tests that have failed. And if we want to look at failures specifically, we can go ahead and we can look at tagging a test failure. So with Testim, you can actually tag test failures. Maybe it's a bug in the app, an environment issue, invalid test design. Let's go ahead and put bug in app. And what I can do here, if you notice, I can create an issue. So what this is going to do is this is going to go ahead and create a particular bug in Jira. As we can see here, here's the link to the test case in Testim, all the steps needed to reproduce the test. And we can see here that actually this link in Jira is linked actually to the test that we have flagged as a test failure. And as we can see here, we've immediately created this issue in Jira. Really helps with efficiency and dramatically reduces the time it takes to, instead of manually having to type up a defect, we can quickly do that with a click of a button within Testim. Okay? So if we go over here to scheduled runs, if we go back over here to runs, we can look at different failure types. We can actually filter on different failures, as you can see in here. If we look at reporting at a very high level, we can get some information about how we're doing over time. So if I wanted to go back and look at a larger time period, I could do that. We can see here that percentage of passed runs is fairly low. So as a team, maybe one of my KPIs is looking at percentage of passes versus failures. You know, 85, 90% is what a lot of teams shoot for. We can see this is dramatically lower than that, but you can get a sense of how your team is trending over time. If we scroll down here, we can see the benefits of tagging failures because we can look at failure types, and we can see that 13% of our failures over the course of the last 3 months were related to environment issues. So you get some visibility into that. Finally, at a very high level, we also integrate with pretty much any CI tool out there available. If you click here and let's say you're using Jenkins, for example, I can easily cut and paste this, put this into my Jenkins pipeline, and quickly start running tests in Testim. So it's a really nice feature there. I could also run locally. This is our command line interface. So if I wasn't using a tool that we directly integrate with, provided that that CI tool has access to a shell where you can install npm in the Testim package, you can actually run tests against Testim or really any Selenium compatible grid just using our command line interface. And finally, just going over here, if you're going through by default, if you saw I clicked on my name and I clicked on settings, everyone has access to the Testim usage examples. If I wanted to get some understanding of other things that we didn't quite touch on in the demo, maybe I wanted to understand how to do API testing, I can get some information and examples on how to do that in Testim. Maybe I wanted to look at how to work with cookies and I had a specific example where I needed to understand how to do that with Testim, I can do that as well. So hopefully this provided a nice overview of how to use Testim, some of the benefits. Feel free to reach out to us if you have additional questions.